At school, before the class began, Setsu, Yuhi and all their classmates got summoned to another world as heroes of Destinia Kingdom, between a ferocious battle between humans and demons. After flunking a giant armored monster, Setsu sensed the creatures were cursed, and the magic traces were familiar to him. This does not surprise Setsu as he was summoned to Destinia before as the previous hero, who successfully ended the last war before being abruptly returned to Japan to restart his life as a baby. The kingdom's king and queen indoctrinated otherworldly recruits about the situation. Elka, Glane and Thea rejoiced at the return of Setsu, who reveals Setsu had disappeared in an explosion while dueling a man named Toma, ending the war, and together they discussed how the war between demons and humans was reignited. After the king and queen declared an all-out war against the demons at the council, Glane relayed the information to Setsu. Setsu suspects Toma has restarted the war by manipulating the demons with cursed magic. Setsu decides not to reveal his identity publicly and will prevent the war by going out on his own to find Toma, leading his teammates to train his classmates. After stealing his old sword Kuramaru from Destinia's armory, before leaving, Setsu revealed to Yuhi that this was his second time being summoned. Setsu rescues a young girl named Ruri from a monster attack, as she is making an important delivery of the last piece of jewelry her grandfather repaired before his death. Setsu agrees to escort her to the next town. There Ruri tries to hire a ship to the demon continent, but all travel there is cancelled due to the war. Bullying royal knights harass Ruri to steal her valuables, but Setsu humiliates them in front of witnesses. At an inn, Setsu peeks at the jewelry while Ruri bathes, and discovers it is a necklace from his previous life he enchanted with protection magic as a gift for a close friend. This worries him. If Ruri's grandfather was asked to repair it, it could only have broken if his friend was in a serious fight and may not have survived. The knights frame them as demon sympathizers and try to arrest them, but they escape when Setsu summons his old friend Leviathan, water dragon and goddess of the ocean, leaving the knights bewildered and terrified. Leviathan agrees to carry them across the sea to the demon continent. Arriving at the continent, Leviathan kills a kraken then transforms into a young woman nicknamed Leviae to scold Setsu for not helping. Setsu makes deep-fried squid as an apology. Ruri reveals her customer is actually Dezastal Deza Sereno, the current demon lord and old friend of Setsu and Leviae. Not wanting to waste food, they take the kraken to Valsea Village, who celebrate as the kraken have ruined their fishing trade. During the party, Ruri realizes Leviae has a crush on Setsu but is angry he vanished for 5 years. Vlad, Deza's bodyguard, sees the party and upon seeing Setsu has returned begs him to save Deza's. Deza's has been cursed and forced to marry Terran Sneeder, the wealthiest human merchant in the world who claims he can arrange peace since humans attacked the demon continent first. Setsu is surprised since humans believe the demons attacked first. Setsu suspects there is a conspiracy to restart the war, which probably includes Terran using his merchant's network to spread false information to rescue Deza's and interrogate Terran. Setsu and Leviae set off to Evil Barrow Deza's castle to stop the wedding. Deza's, who is deeply in love with Setsu, had worked hard to maintain the peace he won before disappearing. One day her necklace mysteriously broke, so she sent it to be repaired but never got it back due to the new war breaking out. Terran eventually offered peace in exchange for their marriage, so Deza's agreed to marry him and wear a new necklace cursed to ensure her slave-like obedience. Terran reports to the conspirators he will soon own the demon continent, though they seem uninterested in whether the war ends or not. Setsu interrupts the wedding in the nick of time to prevent Terran putting the cursed necklace on Deza's, who is overjoyed at Setsu's return. Terran's bodyguard escapes to report back to the conspirators. Setsu confirms the cursed necklace was made by Toma and destroys it before returning Deza's repaired necklace to her, renewing their promise of peace. Next, Setsu decides to visit his other friend Regulus, King of the Beastmen. Terran is arrested and Deza's asks Setsu for a date after the war. Ruri is allowed to open a shop in Deza's kingdom. Setsu and Leviae depart to find Regulus. Flashbacks show Yuhi wanted to attend the same high school as Setsu, even attending extra classes but couldn't get the grades and was heartbroken. until Setsu helped her study. Now in Destinia, Yuhi finds she has a talent for magic and asks Elka and Glane for additional training to become Setsu's teammate faster. Elka is convinced by her skills, but not her resolve. She pits Yuhi against a low-level monster which she defeats but hesitates to kill it. Disappointed, Elka kills it, and Yuhi realizes in a real fight she would only be a liability for Setsu. Thea heals her injuries and reveals Elka was only hard on her because she also wants Elka strong enough to become Setsu's teammate. Yuhi asks Glane how he found his resolve. Glane enjoys hurting his enemies but advises Yuhi to find her own type of resolve. Yuhi defeats another monster but refuses to kill it, having found her resolve to be strong enough to support Setsu without needing to kill. Elka accepts her resolve as it is the same type Setsu once had. The king abruptly decrees Yuhi and her classmates will leave for a mission to the demon continent immediately. Setsu and Levi encounter Ali Z, another of Setsu's students, and her friend Amel. Following Setsu's disappearance, Ali Z worked as a monster slayer and was recently hired by Zathro Village to slay a dragon. Villager Amel was worried her brother had disappeared when the dragon appeared. Ali Z noticed the dragon's victims always just vanished, with no signs of a dragon attack. After injuring the dragon and driving it away, Ali Z found all the villagers had gone missing, except Amel. She is now taking Amel to a city to find someone to look after her. Setsu suspects the villagers were kidnapped by powerful teleportation magic, which by coincidence lured in the dragon, making it seem the dragon was behind the disappearances. From clues in their conversation, Setsu identifies Amel as the culprit. Amel reveals she is a powerful dragon in human form, so Setsu and Ali Z slay her. Setsu and Levi set off to the Beastman continent, while Ali Z stays hoping to find the missing villagers. Returning to Zathro, Ali Z finds Amel is alive. Her real name is Meluer, the master of monsters, and she has been kidnapping people to turn them into powerful doll soldiers for Toma's army. On the Beastman continent, Monster Slayer Shiraniko cares for her sick sister Miniko but struggles as her medicine is expensive. After swimming for 3 days with Setsu on her back, Levi reaches the Beastman continent but demands a rest before going further. In the same town, Shiraniko's boss Kuroinu offers her enough money to care for Miniko indefinitely if she assassinates a troublesome man, Setsu. She attacks Setsu but is easily defeated. Setsu finds she smells of cursed magic, so he returns her to her home but conceals her assassination attempt from Minoke, for which Shiraniko is grateful. Setsu reveals Miniko isn't sick. She is unknowingly wearing another of Toma's cursed necklaces. Setsu removes the curse with his secret weapon Glutton, a sword that devours magic. Kuroinu, another of Toma's agents, tries to kill Setsu but she is defeated by Levi. Kuroinu reveals Toma's goal is to become god and wipe out all living beings, then she teleports away, free of the curse. Miniko and Shiraniko insist on helping Setsu reach Rejdom, the Beastman capital city, while also hoping to find and rescue Kuroinu. In the past, Setsu tutored Roa, the Beastman's princess. Now Setsu returns to Rejdom and finds Roa is eager to become his student. King Regulus is also glad to see him. Learning Toma is behind the war, Regulus and Roa are eager to help. General Ruga insists Setsu's 5-year absence means he can no longer be trusted. He also claims to be Roa's fiancé and is jealous over Setsu. Regulus announces Setsu will duel Ruga to prove his trustworthiness, plus the winner will marry Roa. Ruga reveals a tattoo he received from a sorcerer that converts willpower into strength, even transformed into his beast form, and with the tattoo Setsu still defeats Ruga. Ruga's tattoo takes his jealousy and mutates him, but his body starts to tear apart from the power. Abruptly, Ruga dies horribly as Toma's astral form manifests from his blood, confirming the tattoo was one of his curses. He is thrilled to see Setsu, revealing his grand plan is to kill everything for Setsu so they could fall in love and live together as gods. He vanishes, leaving Ruga's body behind. Setsu, his party, and Roa return to the demon continent to find Toma, while Regulus organizes his army to follow as soon as possible. 10 years ago, Setsu was summoned as Destinia's hero along with Toma. Setsu was furious at being summoned away from his own life just to solve Destinia's problems. Setsu trained to ensure his own survival and entered a pact with Toma to end the war. Setsu decided to explore the world with Elka, Glane, and Thea while Toma stayed in Destinia studying magic. One day Toma encountered a cursed necklace that offered him the power to return to Japan with Setsu, so he took it and immediately afterward learned Setsu had made friends with the leaders of every nation and negotiated peace. With the war over, he told Setsu he could return them to Japan, but Setsu chose to stay. With the curse driving him insane at Setsu's rejection, Toma attacked, resulting in the explosion that sent Setsu back to Japan as a baby. Toma was thrown far away by the explosion, but the curse directed him to a temple where scientists performed torturous human experiments. After destroying it, he rescued four surviving test subjects, Kuroinu, Meluer, and two men. Now Setsu has returned. Toma plans to form a pantheon of gods from himself, the four test subjects, and Setsu. Destinia's army arrives at the demon continent with Setsu's classmates. Elka knows they are unable to stop the fighting without Setsu, so Yuhi decides to prevent as many deaths as possible. Many are killed in the first battle, traumatizing many classmates, and Yuhi has to stop one killing an injured soldier who can no longer fight back. A hypnotized Alize attacks with Toma's doll soldiers and Meluer's summoned monsters, killing both demons and humans to sow chaos. Meluer hopes to similarly hypnotize Setsu's former teammates, but they destroy her monsters, and Elka stabs Meluer in her magic core, destroying her magic power. Meluer doesn't die, revealing as a test subject she was forcibly given extra internal organs to survive fatal injuries and an extra magic core. Using all her remaining power, she summons a giant chimera and fuses herself to it. Alize, who still loves Meluer like a sister, breaks her hypnosis and stabs Meluer. With no power left, Meluer dies in Alize's arms. A male test subject attacks in retaliation for her death. With everyone else exhausted, Yuhi bravely decides to fight him alone, but Setsu arrives just in time. Regulus' army finally sets off to follow Setsu. Yuhi is so happy to see Setsu she nearly kisses him. Setsu is annoyed Elka has been teaching Yuhi masochistic nonsense. The test subject Kajiro is the one who escaped Setsu's attack at Deza's castle and is happy to duel Setsu again. Minako and Shiraniko locate and duel Kuroinu, revealing their ability Beast Merge that fuses them into one body faster and stronger than Kuroinu, who is defeated. Kuroinu reveals she sided with Toma because the scientist's experiments killed all her siblings. The final test subject Virtos possesses synthetic iron muscles, making him immune to injury. Roa fights him, but he reveals his secondary power lets him disintegrate into iron dust, then reform into any shape. Roa is injured by iron cannonballs, but activates her beast form. She manages to crack Virto's armor, despite being impaled by spears, and crushes his heart. Amused by his defeat, Virtos heals Roa's injuries before he collapses. Setsu destroys Kajiro's damage-absorbing armor, and though he doesn't want to, kills him when Kajiro refuses to stop fighting. Toma, sensing all subjects are defeated or dead, appears nearby to finally finish his grand plan. Dezas and Lydia confront Toma, as he was about to kill both. Setsu arrives and saves both. Setsu and Toma start fighting with each other, but Toma was overwhelmed by Setsu's power. Toma revealed his sacred sword's technique that can transform his sword to different weapons. Setsu tries to stop him as he can't let use that destructive power to everywhere. Setsu calls his sacred sword Glutton and absorb all Toma's attack, and uses his power to attack him back. Toma gets angry and blames Setsu to left him alone. Toma gets out of control because of that cursed necklace. He attacks on Setsu's friends, but fortunately they were able to save themselves. Toma's sword transforms into a big cannon. With that, he was able to hit Setsu and he crashed on floor. Toma instantly laughing that he finally defeated the Setsu. Suddenly Setsu woke up and traps Toma in his dimensional magic, as it was his plan to get hit before. Setsu uses his glutton to defeat him by destroying the cursed necklace. Toma asks why didn't he kill him, and he replies it was never his intention, as Setsu promised to always protect him when they were summoned first time. Kingdom decides to use Toma's power for sending back all their classmates back to Japan as punishment, so he'd lose all his magic power and become a normal human. After that, Toma decides to travel the world and says goodbye to Setsu. Later, Setsu and Yuhi also embark on their journey to explore this world. So this is the end of anime. Don't forget to like and subscribe if you enjoyed it.